Hey guys, Rennie here with Off Grid Trek. Wanted to give you an idea of the different solar generator options that we use when we're overlanding, specifically when using our off-road camping trailer. And this is our Tech 5 from South Africa. So not to get into the whole blurb about that, but just to give you an idea, it's got a dual battery setup. Everything's powered from one of our solar blankets. It runs everything, the fridge, freezer, the hot water on demand, the shower. Traditionally we have, and I've got it set up here on the ground so you can see, but traditionally we have one solar blanket with us that partially through the day we can actually run power to this, and we're usually topped up very quick. And then a lot of times we'll either have either an Energy Flex with us, or we'll have an EcoFlow Delta is another really, they're both very, very good options for what's available right now. And basically how we use this, and I don't have everything here to show you, but I'm just gonna go over it. As an example, normally we have a laptop with us, sometimes two. We have a drone with us. We have our emergency radios that we just use for two-way communications. All of our, and by the way, there's a ton of horseflies, so if I'm slapping, I'm sorry about that, guys. But we'll have a couple headlamps with us, depending on how many people are with us. We'll have flashlights as well, GPSs, cameras. So a multitude of devices where literally either of these solar generators are going to provide enough power for that. And then not only that, I've gone to, when travel was a little bit more freer, not that long ago, when we were going to the trade shows, a lot of times I would drive for several hours and I wouldn't have time to actually pull over and charge up. So right from the port here, all I would do is I would just plug into, at the time I was using an Energy Apex, and it's the exact same thing. I would charge from the Energy Apex, and you could do the exact same thing with the EcoFlow Delta here. But I wanted to show you guys the ports on them and just give you a quick comparison. They're very similar. So basically, don't need to go over the pros and cons of both because I think both are very good products for this. Both of them have the 6110 plugins right here. The difference being is this is only 2000 watts surge, whereas it's 3300 watts surge, which really, to be honest, isn't going to matter when you're overlanding. It's not like you're going to be trying to run an AC unit or anything like that, or who's going to bring a hairdryer, or, well, actually it would run a hairdryer, but who's going to bring a hairdryer overlanding? I would hope nobody does. But yeah, just wanted to give you guys an idea. This has two of the USB charging ports, two USB Type-C, two of the DC ports, and I'm just going to show you real quick, as an example, the DC ports right here. Energy has these great little lights. They're chainable. I believe they're 10-foot strands and they're 400 lumen. And I'm just going to show you guys real quick. I haven't mentioned this in the past, but all of our solar blankets as well have the exact same port right on the back on our quick charge box. Not that you're going to run a light, but I'm just going to give you an example here. There you go. So you got a DC type port, you got two high-speed USB ports and a USB type C. And that's on all of our solar blankets as well too. So it has all of that. And the reason I've got these two solar blankets out, I'm just giving you an example how we can charge our trailer. Normally, like I said, we would just have one, but I put two out as an example. And then one's right now fully powering the Energy Flex as well too. Now the EcoFlow Delta, another excellent product. It also has the 6110 plugins, but they're right on the back. That's where they put those. It's fine. It's a little more handy with the Energy Flex to have them on the front, but to me, it's not that much of a big deal. It's got the cigarette lighter plug-in on the back as well too, and I believe that's 13.6 volts, whereas the Energy Flex is it has two on the front, which are 13.8. What EcoFlow has over the Energy Flex is it has four high-speed USB charging ports as opposed to two USB Type-C, but no DC ports. So both excellent products. The other big difference between the two is if you're just looking for a medium standalone system, EcoFlow Delta is excellent because it's 1,260 watt hours and that's your battery pack. However, if you're looking for a system that you can grow, then the Energy Flex would be a better option when comparing these two exact solar generators. Because right now you're seeing one battery pack here. You can actually stack five in total. You can use MPPT superchargers with this, and you can go a total of 96 battery packs. That's huge. So that's kind of that's the big difference between the two. The other option is, or the other thing that I like about the Energy Flex, well, actually, they're both good in this respect, but I do like the fact that compared to a lot of the other manufacturers, what they do, how they allow for solar charging. And we have, for examples here, our 120, our 200, 215 watt solar blankets. They haven't limited your solar charging capability. So we could either use one of our 120s, one of our 200s, one of our 215s, or a combination of three of our 120s, two of our 200s in parallel our series, two of our 215s in parallel our series to charge this specific unit. And then they have the MPPT superchargers, which allows for an additional 800 watts per, which is pretty phenomenal. The EcoFlow Delta, the way they've designed it, and it's actually, it works, it's yeah, you don't need any more for this. You can go maximum of 400 watts, so two of our 200 watts in series, or one 200 watt solar blanket, or one of our 120s, or two of our 120s actually, which is actually based on the size and this, the fact that this is not, how would you call it? It's not expandable. It's actually kind of perfect for how it's designed as well too. Lastly, for these, Energy, when I talked to them last, it sounded like it would be September or later in the fall, somewhere in there, is when they would be, any new orders, if they are accepting new orders, where they would actually be shipping those to customers. So if you're looking for something immediately in this category of solar generators, then EcoFlow would be your better option. If you're willing to wait and you want something that you can grow and expand with, then the Energy is a great option. So that's basically your two choices and our two cents on that. Both really good products. We've used both, we're happy with both, and it just comes down to your needs. And the other thing I was gonna say, guys, like, as you know, there's no cookie cutter way to provide power. There's no one way fits all. So if you guys have any specific needs, just give me a call. My name's Rennie, I'm the owner. Shoot me an email, I'd be happy to answer any questions. The other thing too is, you know, it's a lot of people, they think solar's daunting. We try to keep everything as simple as possible. Even, I'll just pop over here and show you our connectors real quick. Even our connectors, how they are. And I'll show you on the Energy as an example. So the way we've designed these, we use the Anderson SB connectors, and we offer a multitude of other connectors to power many solar generator options, but there's no way to reverse polarity, meaning there's no way to connect it the wrong way. And you'll find with a lot of our packages, and if you just pop over here, I'll show you, a lot of the items are color-coded too. So it makes it really simple. So as an example, you look right here, and I'll just pull this out. Energy has a blue plug that plugs in, and then there's your blue plug. And it's the same, just a different color. If you just pop over here, the EcoFlow Delta, same thing. It's a yellow plug that connects. So it's the reason I'm saying this, I've had a few people comment that where they're finding solar's daunting, and they've contacted me after buying packages and just saying, you know, what goes where? And it just comes down to everything's color coded. Everything's designed where there's only one way it can connect. And we're just trying to simplify it as much as possible for people. But either way, have a great rest of your day, guys. Any questions, please let me know. We're going to do some future videos as well too, regarding what would be good for emergency preparedness. And now again, this is just based on what we've seen and what works well for us. And I'm just going to get out in the sun here because there's a little bit more wind and a little bit less of the horse flies here. But yeah, I'll provide some more videos here in the future. Any questions, let me know, and enjoy the rest of your day. Okay. We'll talk to you guys soon. Thanks, Sam.